Hello guys, welcome back to Conarchy YouTube channel. In our previous video, we learned how to mesh a slab and we learned the importance of meshing a slab. Like if you don't mesh a slab, what happens? Is it very important to do so? And I'm sure you have not already watched that video. Just check with the previous videos and just go through the video and you understand how to mesh a slab and why you would do that. In today's video, we are going to learn how to assign our various load onto our structure. We know like they are setting their specific loads. We have various forms of load. We have dead loads, live loads, seismic, wind loads, and a whole lot of load. But these are the four main loads you'll be looking at: dead, live, seismic, and wind load. So in today's video, we are going to learn how to assign our dead and our live load in today's videos. And in the next videos, I'll be talking much about the wind and the seismic load. So it's going to be very interesting. So just sit back and just get into it. And also don't forget to like and subscribe to the video and also to my channel. And don't forget to also leave a comment in the comment section if there's anything you just want me to know about or just interact with your fellow engineers. So let's get started. So this is where we've arrived at. We are almost done with modeling our structure. If you don't know how we got this structure, just check in our previous videos and it will lead you all the way here. So we are going to assign our load. So first of all, what kind of loads are we going to assign? We need our dead load and also our live load. So we are going to assign our dead and our live loads. So let's first of all assign them to our slab. So we are going to assign loads to our slab. So before we assign a load, as I said earlier, if you want to assign some command to a specific element, you have to select the element first. So first of all, let me select my slab. I don't want to go through the stress of just selecting them one at a time. I just want to select them all together. So properties, then slab sections. They are all 180 mm slab. So 180 mm slab, then I'll just select, then all my slabs have been selected and I'll just have to close this one. So what loads are we going to assign? So our dead and our live load. So we know that our slab is a shell object, so shell. Okay, so just look at this. Most of the options here have not been highlighted or something. Yeah, I can't really click on any of them. This is because my window is locked. It happens when you run your analysis. So before you do anything, you just have to unlock this. So just click on this and just okay. And now when I go to assign, now all the options are showing. So shell, assign, I'm about to assign shell loads. So shell loads and uniform. So let me drag this here so you can actually see what's happening. So first of all, our dead load. So with the dead load, I'm going to assign dead load of 2 kilonewton per meter square, and it will be in the gravity direction. And also, let's make it 3. So 3 kilonewton per meter square. And replace existing. So this is not really, I'm just teaching how to go about assigning your load. So I don't really have a specific load I'm using. So if you have a specific load you use, then just go by it. So dead load, 3 kilonewton per meter square. In the gravity direction, and you can also use add to existing load or just replace existing load. So for the replace existing load, if you don't know that this your object already has a dead load on it, if you've a dead load has been assigned on it, but maybe you want only this 3 kilonewton per meter square load to be on it, you can just replace it. So any existing load will be replaced and this will be the new load. So I don't really know if there's a load has been assigned on it, so I'm just going to click replace. But just in case you have 1 kilonewton maybe finishes, you want to add another dead load, you just go to add to existing load, and so it will keep on adding up. So dead load, then apply. So I've applied the 3 kilonewton load to all of my slab. So I'm going to assign a live load now. So I don't want to just go to select, and so there's this option here that's get previous selection. I can just click this and I also get the objects I previously selected. So down they're all selected. So live load of maybe 2 kilonewton per meter square. So I have to change this to live. So dead and live. So you can see that we don't have seismic or wind here. It's very normal because with the ETABS up there, default loads here are the dead and the live. So for you to get the seismic and the wind loads and all those other loads, you just have to define them. So when we get to assigning our earthquake and our wind loads, I'll teach you how to, you know, define those loads. But for now, let's concentrate on the dead and the live. So live, 2 kilonewton load, also replace existing load. It's in the gravity direction. Then I'll just have to click on apply. So now you can see I have my 2 kilonewton. The moment you just apply it, will just show on your slab. So now I've applied my dead load and my live load. These are the loads I need. And also I'm going to close this. So I'm done assigning my dead load and my live load. And another important thing here is also with these beams, sometimes, most of the times, these beams are, you know, there are these block works on the beam. There are these block works or maybe partition walls on the beams. So for the exterior, even with the interior beam, sometimes there are these block works, you know, just dividing the building into, you know, yeah. So for that block works on the beam, they also put some form of loads onto the beam, some form of UDL onto the beam. So we have to know, if you can't really picture what I'm trying, just look at this. So I'm going to show you a picture. This is a beam over here, and these are block works on the beam. So these block works also assign some form of loads onto this beam. So we are going to also assign these block work load. These are dead loads, so we are going to assign them on the beam. So let's go back to, so these are the beams. So I'm going to select every single beam. So select area property frames sections, and our beam is a B1. So B1, and I'm going to select and close. So now all my beams have been selected. So I'm going to assign that block loads in the form of UDL. And you have to know how to calculate them block loads. So like for you to calculate them, to calculate the loads, it's just the unit weight of the block works times the thickness of the block work times the height of the floor. So from here to here, we know that our story height is 3 meters. So let's input that here. So so I have my unit weight of the block works to be 23 kilonewton per meter square. So 23, that's the unit weight, times the thickness of the block work. The thickness, it should be in meters. So let's say the thickness is 220 millimeters. So in meters, 0.22, times the height of the building. The height of the building, we know that the story height is 3. Then equal. So now this is our UDL. So this is the UDL on the beam. So we have 15.18. So yes. So we are going to assign our UDL. So assign our beam is a frame. So frame loads, it's not a point by a distributed. So distributed load. And I'm going to, so it's a force, a dead load, replace existing load because I've not really applied any load on the beam. So yeah, so the loads, I'm going to input, what was the load again? Oh, I've closed it, but it was somewhere around 15. So 15 kilonewton per meter. Then I'll just hit on apply. So now I have my UDL loads it's a UDO, so 15 kilonewton on the beam. So all around I have my UDO. So okay, so once I'm done, so I've applied all my loads on this, my dead load, my live load and everything. So I can also, because we are going to be dealing with seismic and also wind load, let's increase our story height. So we are going to edit this structure. It's just a two-story, but we want multiple stories, like let's say five-story. So we want to get five-story. So we are just going to edit. So before we replicate the story, we need to, you know, just give some grid lines. So we have to increase the grid line so that our members can, you know, just fit into the grid line. So we are just going to edit story or grid system, then modify story data. So right now we want to just replicate the story to we want to add like three other stories to the structure we have here. So once you come to the editing the story, we just right click here. So right click, add story, keep existing story height. So we are going to replicate the story too. So we are going to keep the story height and also everything on. So story height, we have 3 meters. That's the same as the story too. Number of stories, we want to add three other stories to it. So three, number of stories, three. New story location, insert above story two. It will be like above story two. And replicate new story. For this feature, it replicates and everything that's on story two. So in our structure, we have our slab, our beam, our column, and our staircase all in story two. So you can, if you want the same thing to be similar throughout the various stories that you are going to create, you can just from existing story, you know, from story two, then you just continue. But if you want them to be different, if you don't want them to be similar, you just click on none and you just make the required editing to the new stories created. But in our scenario, like the various stories above are similar, so we are going to keep from existing story, replicate new story. So you're just replicating it. So three stories or 3 meters, then okay. So now we have five stories. So we have three extra stories that have been added, all of 3 meters, 3 meters. So now let's go and look at our structure, how it looks now. So now that's it. We have three new stories that has been added, but because we kept our existing story, so we replicated story two. And so every feature on story two replicated here. So now we have all these members over here, but if you wanted to change it, if you don't want them to be the same, we would have just clicked on none, but we wanted them to be similar. So that's it for replicating the story. So all the loads that we applied are also on these various slabs that we've created. So right now, let's try to just run this and just show you the shear force, the bending moments in this building. So first of all, we also have to remember that like we have to change all these supports at the bottom here. We have to change them from pin to fixed supports. So we have to change them from pin to fixed. So we go to the plan view, then to the base, and okay. So with all the supports here, I'm going to assign a fixed support. So joint, restraints, then fixed. So apply. So now all my supports at the bottom are all fixed now. So don't forget to do that once you're about to run your analysis. So fix all your bottom joints. So that's at the foundation level. So once everything has been fixed and we are done with applying the loads and the dead load, let's run it to see what we are going to get. So run analysis. So now the analysis is complete, and this is some of the deformed shape, how the structure is going to know just deform under the various loads. So this is it, and also you can also see the reactions at the bottom. So you can just, I can just show you the reactions at the bottom. So with the dead load, I'm going to show the reactions at the bottom. So apply. So just looking at it, so for the dead load, the total dead load node just going into the foundation or being transferred into the foundation, this is the dead load for this column. For this column to has its own dead loads, so that various dead loads. So for the live load too, you can just apply and you see so the dead load, these are the loads that are going into the foundation. I think for the live load, we didn't apply the live load. That's why it's not really showing here. But if you also did it correctly, you also see arrows for the live load. So that's it for the loads. So that's what you are going to use to design your foundation and stuff. So now we have this display frame. So let's look, check for our Axial force, our moment, our shear force in the building. So you can, if you want to see the Axial forces in the building, just click on Axial forces. We want to show the values at the control stations and just hit on apply. Yeah, so as I said earlier, my live load wasn't applied. So if you did it correctly, everything is supposed to show. So I've changed mine to dead load now. So I'll just have to click on the apply. So now these are, this is the Axial forces. Let me put them in the elevation mode so you can, elevation view, so you can see them properly. So this is the Axial force, and you can notice that it increases as it gets to the bottom. The internal forces in the structure, like, it's increasing because for every story it's transferring the loads downwards. So that's for the Axial. We also have shear 2-2, and also that's showing for the shear forces in the various members. And we also have our moment 3-3. So these are the also, these are also the moments in the various members. So you can see the, for this beam, the maximum bending moment is around like 29 kilonewton meter. So this is also another, the maximum bending moment for this beam too. You also have this in sagging and also hugging moments at the top here. So that was it for getting your shear force and bending moment for these various diagrams. So now we are done analyzing the building, but in our next video we will be assigning our shear our seismic loads and also our wind loads. Then once we are done, we'll just design the building and see which members are failing, those who are not failing, and we'll see to pass those members that are failing. So that was it for today's video. Don't forget to like and also subscribe to today's channel, today's video, and also the channel. And also, if there's anything you want to know about, just leave a comment in the comment section and I'll get back to you as soon as possible. Thank you.